Hey everyone, I'm Erin Bassett. Today I'm going to be sharing with you about how I transformed the cigar box into a little piece of art. So I started by taking the box and covering the outside with some gesso so that it would be a great foundation to continue with. Next, I took some Texture Luxe in this beautiful copper color and started brushing it onto the lid of my box, and then it dawned on me that I should probably have a little bit of patina showing through since it is copper. So I brushed some of this bluish greenish color on and then continued applying the Texture Luxe. Once that had dried, I went ahead and taped off the edges since it has a bit of a beveled edge to it, and I just wanted to keep my design right on the top part. Next, I took some whip spackle and I applied it on top of one of my favorite stencils, and that added a lot of texture and dimension to the top of the box. Now I knew I wanted a little bit more texture on there, so I took one of my rubber stamps and just stamped it right in there. And this is an alphabet one, so it gave it a really cool look to it. Then I went ahead and removed the stencil and the tape around the edges and let it dry. And then once it was dry, I was ready to get started on painting all those little individual fractures. And I just use a variety of acrylic paints for this. So I just kept painting them until all of them were filled. I also used that acrylic paint to paint around the bottom of the box, and really it was just whatever color my brush happened to dip into. There was no rhyme or reason to it since it was an undercoat of painting. And then next I applied that same stencil right onto the edge, and I used a sponge and some acrylic paint to just dab it right on there so that the repeating pattern could just tie it all together. And next, I took my Pit Artist pen and just traced around those shapes. And after that, I went ahead and took my paintbrush and took the end of it, dipping it into that Texture Luxe that I had used earlier, and just made little dots randomly all over the bottom of the box. I also used that Pit pen to trace around the top of the box around each of those little fracture pieces as well. So then I put aside the whole thing to dry and thought about what I wanted to do for embellishments. And I found this cute little metal piece in my collection, and I took again some of that Texture Luxe and just wiped it all over it. And it filled in a little bit of the lettering, but I didn't have a problem with that because I figured I could either clean it up or just take my Pit pen and write right over it. And for the last of my embellishing, I took some copper wire and threaded it through my little metal piece, and then took beads and strung them on there, made little curlicues with the copper wire, and put it all together with some feathers and some trim pieces I had, and then I was all finished. For more information on the products that you've seen here, go to designmemorycraft.com. And for more information on this project and other fun, inspiring craft ideas, visit erinbassett.com. You can also subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking subscribe.